Okay, so this video is not part of the regularly scheduled programming, but I wanted to make it anyway because it's part of my life, and life is getting in the way right now, my real life work. So what I'm going to talk about is how I responsibly get over a breakup. So if you're like me, you're kind of an emotionally void robot, and you don't like feeling feelings, especially bad ones. And because you don't like feeling them, you kind of like ignore them and reject them and pretend everything's okay. Until one day you're walking around a parking lot for 7 hours at a time listening to Fiona Apple on repeat, and then you realize that you can't sleep or eat or do your work. And then it's time to address a problem. So that's where I was at, where I am at. And I guess, and there's a couple reasons that you could be feeling bad for a breakup. It could be that you are the person who broke up with someone and you don't want to make them feel bad. Could be that someone randomly broke up with you and it's like devastating and you want to die and you weren't ready for it and came out of nowhere so you couldn't even prep for it. I'm not going to say which is my case, but regardless, it still sucks either way. So I just wanted to give some tips of how I get over a breakup. Number one, the first thing you can do is put your whole business on YouTube. I'm just kidding. So the first thing that I do when I find out that I'm wallowing in grief and I need to get out of it is that I make sure I feel pretty. And so today what I did was I took care of my skin. I did a coffee coconut almond scrub, and then I did a turmeric honey moisturizing mask, and I did my nails, which I haven't been doing for a long time because I wasn't going to buy any nail polish until I invested in non-toxic nail polish, but I don't have time for that, nor do I have the money to buy nail polish that costs $16 a pop when I'm probably going to need like 5 different colors. But anyways, painted my nails with some toxic nail polish that kills women, and I did facial and I feel much better. The second thing that I do is retail therapy, and I'm going to do that in just a moment right now. But you need to do retail therapy in moderation. Like, moderation means don't break the bank just because you feel sad inside. For me, for example, I usually have a list of things I need to buy that I haven't gotten to. I'm really scared. I'm under an overpass right here. I usually have a list of things that I need to buy that I haven't gotten around to yet. So it kind of just go to that list and see what I need to get. I have fun things on my list. Like, I have, I need to buy an outfit for a bachelorette party. And I also need to buy eyeliner. So I'll be doing that shortly. But don't go overboard, and definitely don't do it like online, because online you'll probably just be back on the internet stalking whatever the person is that you just left. All right, the third thing you can do is to eat, in moderation, if you are not eating. I was not eating. I was going hours and hours and hours and hours without walking around in the sun, pacing, because that's what I do. And I wouldn't eat until I was like pretty much famished, and that's not good, and it doesn't make me feel good. There's actually studies that show that a lot of your emotions are tied to your stomach, which is why some people have like gut feelings, or they describe things like that coming from their stomach, not actually your heart, but your stomach. And that's because there are chemicals that come from your stomach that do affect your emotions. So by not eating and you feel empty and void inside, it is almost like you're intentionally trying to feel empty and void emotionally, and that's not good. So for me, I didn't have an appetite, but what I would do was, again, walk and walk until I got famished enough that I did eat, and then when I did, I always felt good. Or I was meeting up with friends who would have talks with me, but during the talks we would be like at a cafe or something, and they would order food, and then I would end up picking off of their plate, and I always felt much better. So eat food, and eat healthy food, and don't eat chocolate or caffeine or sugar or things that you're allergic to or things that are harmful. Try to eat healthy, wholesome, whole foods. Okay, the last thing is exercise, and I would say you can either do the type of exercise that I'm doing right now, which is just walking around or taking a leisurely bike ride, just to get your, it's almost like meditative, like you get to think and you get to be active at the same time. Or you can do like super painful workout, which would definitely take your mind. There are a lot of homeless people here because I'm on the side of a freeway, actually under the overpass. I'm gonna go this way. But yeah, there are, or you can do a very painful workout, which would replace the emotional pain that you're feeling, at least for that moment, take your mind off of it. But either way, it's just good to, Either way, you'll be breathing deeply, and it'll be very cathartic, and you'll have your mind off of it for a moment, and you won't be again in front of the computer staring at that person or seeing any negative or positive messages that they are trying to send at you, which is not helpful. But yeah, these are the only tips I have. I just recently felt better, so I decided that I'd do this video as a way to be productive. I mean, I already lost like 4 days of work with all this drama, but at least now I have a video out of it. But the most important thing to remember is that in the end, you have to decide that you're not going to sit in your grief, because all of these things I just said, whether even if they are healthy, they're just kind of band-aids. In the end, you have to just decide that you're not going to sit in it. You're not going to be sad anymore, and you're going to do something about it. And you're not going to let it be an excuse that you can't for the other things that you're not doing in your life. So, I mean, this is all better than doing, like, sleeping with random people or doing drugs or alcohol, which are escaping, and they don't fix the problem. But at the same time, like, I mean, in the end, the whole point of everything in this channel, and I mean, it should be your life, is to get better. And I don't think you'll ever get better if you don't learn to deal with pain and get over it and heal yourself. I mean, it's not even just for yourself. Like, you're never going to be able to help anyone else, or help your future children, or help your younger brother and sister, or help anyone else that's in your life, if you don't even know how to effectively deal with things on your own. So this is just good practice. There's a quote that I really like, and it says that you need to fight the way you practice, or something like that. I'll put it up later. But it's basically saying, like, if you never practice doing hard things or becoming stronger and things like that, when it comes down to it, and when hard things really do pop up or difficult things are in your life, you're never going to be ready for them. Like, never, ever, ever. You should be getting better every day, though. Okay, my battery's gonna die. I just want to say that the only positive thing that came out of this was that I found an artist that I used to really like, and he had a song called Life Goes On, and I'll play it right now. And there'll be a link in the description, but I was really excited to find that the other day. All right, that is it. Yeah. Bye.
Goes on, no matter if your life is tattered and you can't fix what went wrong. Life goes on, the pattern in your life is tattered. You're a hook in your own theme song. Life goes on, you're a fighter, but the grip is tighter, and you know that you can't stand long. Life goes on, oh, it's gonna get brighter. Life goes on, oh, it's gonna get brighter. Life goes on. If ever you're hungry, you should never feel lonely if God is with you. If I go, know that I will make a return. Give me frankincense, myrrh, ashes in the urn. But learn, life goes on.